Yo, what's up, my brother? What's up, my sister? This is your boy, Oscar Ntege, again with yet another amazing video. Guess what in this video? In this particular video today, I'm going to show you how to properly edit skin in Photoshop using a technique called frequency separation. This is what professionals use to do high-end skin retouching for their portraits. And if you want to make more money and attract high-paying clients, of course, high-end retouching would be the way to go. So let's get onto computer. I show you the best way in which you can retouch skin. Ready? Let's dive into this. Now, we are here in Photoshop right now, and this is the image we're going to edit. We're going to use a technique called frequency separation. You're not going to go through the whole process that I've been teaching you in my previous videos. This time I made an action pack for you. You're going to use in the post-production of all these pictures. So you can download the action pack just right below in the first link in the description below so that you put it into your Photoshop. If you want to learn how to install the action pack, just click on the video up there and of course, see how we install the pack. So here you come into frequency separation here, as I told you. So we are going to look for the actions. You come here into window, then you click onto the action panel. And then right here, you're going to come and click, look for the dynamic action pack. If you have the dynamic action pack, definitely you're going to look for a frequency separation action that has 50 MP. This particular image is shot with a Nikon 850. It is quite a big camera, so it has almost 45 megapixels. So I did a frequency separation action for cameras that are above 50 megapixel, and if you're editing an image that is below 50 megapixels or below rather 45 megapixels, like a 24 megapixel camera, you're going to use the beauty frequency separation. That is the action pack I did for you guys. So you come here into the beauty frequency just right here, and then you play the frequency separation action. So now we are just going to go and begin working on to the textures first. Then later on, we're going to go and work on to the skin tones. Now the bottom layer, this one, the one in the middle, is for colors. I'm going to rename it to colors. And this one is going to be for textures, just like that. So we are first going to come and work onto the texture layer, but we want to get the texture all seen. So what you do, you come here into the texture layer, and then rather here into the adjustment layers down here, and then you say black and white, and then we are going to pull down the reds so that we bring all the blemishes, we make the blemishes all visible, just like that. Yeah, just there. And then we come, click onto the texture layer, and then we zoom in, and we're going to get our clone stamp. I love using the clone stamp. We're going to add in the hardness so that it's not soft, and then we're going to keep the opacity and flow at 100. So make sure it is current layer that is selected just right there. And then what you're going to do, you're just going to come press Alt or Option on your keyboard, then click to select a smooth part and then patch it up there like that and like that. So that's how the clone stamp works. You press Alt on your keyboard, then you, so we're going to come and do fast cleaning up like that. So we get rid of all these white heads, and you know, the process really takes a bit of time, but you know, the results are really worth it. There are new softwares that they are doing that enable you to do most of these things a bit automatically, but the problem I have with most of them is that they just blur out the skin. Like, in a way, I don't want to mention really brands, but the image tends to look more of like a Snapchat filter. So that's why I choose to do it manually. Maybe with time, I think the technology is going to improve, you know, and we have it, you know, perfect. But I know that the other softwares that can really do it, like Retouch for me, are a bit pricey, but they're fair enough, I would have to say. Not really as compared to the manual editing, if you know the retouching stuff, but they save you a lot of time. Okay, so we remove all these blemishes like that. I don't want the video to be so long, so I won't really perfect it, but you will perfect it in your post-production. Yeah, so the next thing we're going to do right here, we're just going to come now begin working on the tonal layer. So we've worked on the textures, now we are going to work on the colors. I prefer using the Gaussian blend to the mixer brush. Reason being, the mixer brush would require you to be a very excellent artist. It is much more of a sculpting, and you know, and I've seen most people who use the mixer brush, every image of theirs has a particular shape they give to the nose, and that is not how the real world is. In reality, people don't have similar noses. They tend to give people straight noses by giving them that distortion. So it requires you to be a bit of an artist. So what we are going to do right now, we use the Gaussian blur. I use the Gaussian blur because it is more precise, and even if you're not very, very artistic, it will give you some nice, cool results. Okay, let us roll with this. So we're going to come here with our lasso tool. We put the feather here at 18, and then we are just going to come and select these particular parts, and then we come into filter, we say blur, you say Gaussian blur, and then we are going to push it to 0, and then we come and just push it forward just like that. Don't take it overboard, because you end up getting somebody who has a flat skin. You want to keep it at a level where you still see the skin texture and these highlights without them being getting lost. So we just come in, but for the sake of this video, I'll take it a bit overboard. I don't know how your computer sees it. And then we come and repeat the same action by pressing Alt or Control Alt and F, or Command Option and F if you're using a Mac, to repeat the similar action just like that. We go all through the same process over and over again like that, and then still do the same. We come into these areas right here, there. And by the way, if you want to improve your color grading, I have an exquisite color LUTs pack I did for you guys. You can also click the second link in the description below to get a copy of the exquisite color LUTs pack, so that you take your color grading to the next level. Actually, this is one click color grading, so just click the second link in the description and get the exquisite color LUTs pack for your next projects, whether you're doing weddings, whether you're doing events or portraits, whatever photography genre you're doing. This LUT pack is going to help you transform the outlook and quality of your images. So click the second link in the description and get it for yourself. Okay, so let's continue. I just come here again and then press Control F to repeat, Command F, and then come into the neck area, do the same. And right there. And guess what, guys? That is how you edit skin in Photoshop. I'll just zoom it in. Okay. That's the before, and this is the after. The before and after. When you look at this particular technique, we have not actually lost the texture, but all we have done, we have maintained the texture, and at the same time, we have put the skin tones right. We've just made the makeup right. So look at the before and after. Isn't that amazing, guys? Okay, that's that for today. I hope you've learned something. In the comments below, tell me what has really resonated with you, and what are you struggling with as a photographer, as a retoucher? I would look into my schedule and see how I can do a video for it. Just tell me what you're struggling with as a photographer, and I will assist you in your next endeavors. All I want you to do is to get the best is for you to become the best photographer that you've always wanted to be. I want you to make money from your skill. And that is all I wish for you. That's that for today. I'll see you in the next video, and adios.